Bama match before. He has been to, like, the past... Like, he's been to 15 tournaments that I've been to.
Yeah.
Most of them Shockwaves. And every single time, he gets out right before I get on. So now I finally get to tell you about all of the crazy stuff that he's bringing to the table with the Link. Going up against Cheeks, you know, who we just saw recently beat Cethlon to get here in winner's quarters.
You'll see that fair from Cloud normally when space is really, really nice, but when it's not spaced out, even Link can grab that. Mm-hmm. Of course, he does have that normalized grab in this game.
Yeah, no hookshot, which is a blessing or a curse depending on who you are. I know that Jamma's not too upset with it. He actually makes really good use of the grab.
I think most people are very happy with it.
Yes.
The biggest, I think, complaint possible is I don't have Zair anymore.
Which was great for Link getting off ledge, but now he has so many options to do it, like pressuring with that bomb.
Ooh, Climb Hazard not getting both hits. Jamma,
the up B countered by the up B.
Definitely could have been a bigger punish. I don't even know what happened to Cheeks down there.
Cheeks just went too hard, and I believe he air dodged or just committed to a very laggy move.
First hit bear has always been nice for Link getting something started.
Wow, Jamma just flying down with that downer.
Man, I feel like these people have played a good amount because we're seeing that Cheeks is unfazed by the bomb play.
Yeah, I mean, they both play a lot in Denton, man. Mm-hmm. And, you know, now that they're here, they get to show it on the Shockwave stage. And right now, it looks like Cheeks is just having a little bit of trouble dealing with Jamma actually in that boxing
range.
Oh,
he activated. That was actually really smart, but unfortunate that Jamma was too close. He tossed the bomb to activate the blade beam, but it was still close enough that the activated blade beam hit him.
He got hit in the blast radius.
I think it caught him because his arm was extended out from tossing out the bomb.
Mm. Sometimes you just gotta shield him, man. Wow, he tried to hit him with the hero spin.
There we go. Forward throw has been nice. It looks like down throw at these percents isn't gonna get him anything, so he wants all that stage position.
We saw that he spot dodged after that jab 1-2, which indicates that, you know, playing Cheeks before, he loves to get aggressive as soon as possible out of shield against Jamma, which makes sense considering that, you know, he's playing Link. You want to try to break that zone and get up close. But like I said, man, when Jamma's been up close, he's been winning a whole lot of interactions with Cheeks.
Pulling out that arrow. Seldom seen from the adult Links.
Yeah, however,
Jamma, that's a big punish.
Jamma uses it a lot, but one thing that he uses way too much is that hero spin. It's a very powerful move.
It's a commitment, though.
It's a big ol' commitment. Big ol' hitbox, big ol' power, big ol' commitment. That's just how it goes.
Probably one of his faster out of shield options, maybe his fastest. That's why we're not maybe seeing Nair out of shield in that situation, as he wants that speed. But there we go. That time, gonna get the kill with it. That too, it does kill much sooner than any of those other out of shield options if he's getting a punish like that.
I mean, that's the thing about that up B out of shield, and you know, especially just using it at all to punish, is that you want to do it on whiff punishes. You want to do it on the laggy moves. You don't want to preemptively do it because you know he's going to hit you with a forward air or a climb hazard. Like, that's not enough time to use that hero spin to punish it.
There we go, covering that with a boomerang.
Ooh, not in shield grab range, and Jamma was too antsy to get it done.
Air dodge is down. He's fine.
Yeah, that was I think that was just a fast fall air dodge.
So the way that directional air dodges work is you gain your control after you've moved a certain distance again, not a certain amount of time.
Ah.
So if you directional air dodge down, you can move sooner than if you had like gone up.
I see.
You still have to reach the same amount of distance traveled. That's why, and it's a universal distance too. That's why when like Jigglypuff goes for a directional air dodge, it looks like she is inactionable for so much longer than other characters, because she is.
Right.
She's slowly floating that way down.
That makes
like
sense.
Like a fast faller like Fox.
That's good to know. I never would have guessed that. Would have just been like, dang, I just missaw that air dodge then, I guess, because he was able to act quickly.
3, 2, 1. Now, taking this one to town and city.
Much more room to toss these projectiles up. There's a little bit, I don't want to say claustrophobic in game one, but it was definitely a lot harder to get that game plan going, where now, once he gets Cheeks a little bit of a distance away from him, then he can get up those walls again. I love the way that Jamma uses the arrow so much.
There you go. Yeah. We really didn't see in game one much bomb play at all. It was kind of sitting on a platform the whole time. So we'll see if the bombs can come out a little bit more to play this game. Catching the jump out of shield with the fair.
Oh, yeah.
Forced that limit termination.
Yeah, I agree with you with the bomb. It looked like Jammo was trying to utilize it sort of in the same way that Snakes used the C4.
Just cover that one plat bit.
But the problem was that he was covering behind him. He was waiting for Cheeks to cross him up, but Cheeks said, well, I don't need to go behind you if the bomb's over there. But that's one of the things. He loves to do some baseball, man. He likes to set up some bunts, get a little bloop single, and hit that bomb right at you.
Is a bloop single a real term?
Yes.
What the heck is a bloop single?
I will explain to you later.
All right. So back there tries to set up on the plat. Doesn't quite work out, though. Gets the ledge.
Ooh. Okay, I love that back air there from Cheeks, but Jammo is low profiling it because of when he got down. Oh, my goodness.
Jammo's on fire. Somebody get him a red tunic.
Get that fire extinguisher out, man. I need type C stat. Oh, my
he
gosh.
He has to use the limit.
He is looking like a type C fire extinguisher. He is smothering Cheeks.
Jammo is actually playing so hot right now. Back air not going to be able to punish. Gets too high too quickly.
Yeah, this is the exhibit A of fighting fire with fire, man.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, I think Cheeks knew. He was like, all right, Jammo just wants to hit me? Fine. He's going to come down on me with the down air, and I'll just smack him with my own sword. Wow. That's
some good damage. He almost comboed cross-slash to cross-slash.
That makes me upset. I love that up B, by the way. The reason that Jammo goes for that is because if Cheeks decides to jump off of that platform, which most people will, that will carry him all the way into the blast.
Right, and you can react to the fact that you've got that hit confirm and start drifting out and get that stock.
There are clips on, like, every Smash highlight channel of Jammo doing that. Like, it is not an uncommon thing for him to do. Oh, he air dodged, though. He was afraid. And then he tried to compensate for that by drifting further into Cheeks to try to act quickly, and by that time, he was already done with the cross slash. I don't want to say comeback city right now for Cheeks, but he's definitely going to get off the second stock at this rate.
Gets that dash attack to cover, but
DI.
How's he going to...
Yeah. I think he panicked a little bit between, okay, the analysis paralysis, right? He was like, do I do the bomb or can I make it with Hero Spin? And by the time he made up his mind, he was already dead.
Dang,
oh
so
gosh.
Many climb hazards. My favorite thing about watching Cheeks play is he goes for stuff like that, and if you look at the player cam, he's stoic as hell.
Yeah, he's like,
this is the option I want to be doing.
Optimal.
But Jammo is opting for way too many aggressive options right now. He's starting to panic that he hasn't gotten that stock off yet.
See what he's holding forward.
Yeah, and Cheeks is just holding still and making him come to him.
You got projectiles, you don't got to dash in for the nair, the jab. Set up his own. Yeah, he didn't react to the situation there. He was already pressing that up tilt.
The worst way to do that? You don't want to see it end that way. Cheeks makes the comeback, but the way it ends. That's unfortunate, man. We hang out with each other too much.